Assalamualaikum and very good morning to all of you, dear students. We are learning class 9 science, biology. Dear students, if you remember that from the last previously videos, we are observing some of the prominent slides which we have in our biology lab. Yes, dear students, before that we had observed the some of the epithelial tissues which are there present in our body, how they look, what is their location, what is their structure and what is their function, right? Okay, I hope you people now clear with the epithelial tissue, dear students. Now today further we are moving with the second type of tissues, that is muscular tissue, or we can say the muscle tissues, dear students. So first of all, here I want to tell you something, that muscles tissue, what do you mean by muscles? First of all, that this particular tissue is mainly attached with the bones, not only attached with the bones, another also at some of the specified organs this particular tissue is present. Getting, dear students? So this, what is the main function of this muscles tissue or muscular tissue? That muscles tissue is mainly responsible for movement in our body. Getting that, dear students? You people are mightly heard with the biceps, yes, or the abs. Okay, so these all are the muscles which are present in our body. So as this particular muscles having fibers inside them, they are called as muscles fibers, and this particular tissue is responsible for the movement of the body. As when we were learning about the epithelial tissue, we learned that epithelial tissue is mainly for the protection, for the physical protection of our body. So same here, the main function or the main motto of this muscular tissue is to give movement to our body. Actually what happened, dear students, that this particular muscles, whatever the muscles are there, there are so many different types of muscles are present in our body actually, but so whatever the muscles are present in our body, they contain a special kind of protein. And that particular protein is responsible for the contraction and relaxation, and due to that contraction and relaxation, our body allows to move. If we are stretching our fingers, we can move our hand, we can bend our hand from the elbow, we can bend our leg from the knee. So all this movement possible, all this movement occur only and only because our muscles can contract and relax. And why our muscles has the ability to contraction and relaxation? Because our muscles having a special kind of protein. This is also one mark question also, dear students, that which protein is responsible for the movement in muscles. So the answer of that particular protein is contractile proteins, contractile, contractile proteins. From the name only you can able to understand that this particular proteins are able to contract also and relax also, and due to the contraction and relaxation of this particular protein, the movement can be possible. Okay, so already we have learned about three different types of muscles tissue present in our body, that is smooth muscles, or we can say striated muscles, or you can also say voluntary muscles. Voluntary muscles, what do you mean by it? That we can move with our will. Okay, so voluntary muscles, involuntary muscles and cardiac muscles. So let's begin with it, dear students. Okay, so dear students, this is an activity of the muscles tissue. So what are the learning outcomes of this particular activity that we have to describe over here? That we describe the major functions of the muscles tissue, that which different kind of muscles tissues are present in our body and what are the functions of that. Okay, then after we are comparing and contrasting the structural and functional characteristics characteristics of skeletal muscles, cardiac muscle and smooth muscles. Also, as now I told you that skeletal muscle, cardiac muscle and smooth muscle or unstriated muscles also we can say they are present. Okay, then provide examples of the location of each type of muscles tissue in our present in our body. Means particular tissue is present where, in which organ in our body, that we will describe over here. Okay, and one very important thing here they had given, dear students, that is neuromuscular junction. Okay, that we will talk about in detail afterwards. Okay, so first is introduction given over here, dear students, that muscle tissue is highly specialized to contract and produce most types of body movement. Yes, as now I told you that we can move our body, can move our different organs of our body can move due to the contraction and relaxation of this muscles. Okay, so as you might expect, muscle cells tend to be elongated, providing a long axis for contraction, and three basic types of muscle tissue are exposed in lab. Okay, so we are moving with that particular tissue, dear students. Okay, so the first one is skeletal muscle. Okay, now in this activity we will observe skeletal muscles, or we can say striated muscles also, or we can say the voluntary muscles also, under the microscope. So first of all, let's talk about why different names are given to this particular tissue, dear students, because as now I told you they are called as voluntary muscles, because as now I told you that we can move some muscles by conscious will. अगर हमारी मर्जी होती है तभी हम उसी पर्टिकुलर ऑर्गन्स को या उस पर्टिकुलर मसल्स को मूव कर सकते हैं, हिला सकते हैं, दैट इज़ ऑन आवर विल. अगर हमारी मर्जी नहीं है तो हम उसको मूवमेंट नहीं देते हैं. सो दैट इज़ व्हाई दे आर कॉल्ड एज वॉलेंटरी मसल्स, बिकॉज दे आर ऑल अंडर आवर विल. Now, muscles present in limbs move when we want them to. What are limbs? Actually, human body having two limbs, fore limbs and hind limbs. Fore limbs are our hands and hind limbs we can say our legs. Okay, so whenever we want to move them, we are moving, and whenever we want to stop, so we decide. Okay, so that is why such particular muscles are called as voluntary muscles. These muscles are also called as skeletal muscles, dear students, because they are mostly attached with the bones. जी, ये जो पर्टिकुलर टिश्यू है वॉलेंटरी मसल्स, वो नॉर्मली बोन्स के साथ अटैच्ड होते हैं एंड बॉडी मूवमेंट में हेल्प करते हैं. दे आर हेल्पिंग इन द बॉडी मूवमेंट. सो दैट इज़ व्हाई वी कैन से दिस पर्टिकुलर मसल्स एज स्केलेटल मसल्स ऑल्सो. नाउ व्हाट इज़ द लोकेशन? द स्केलेटल मसल्स, और वी कैन से द मीट. Now you're getting which are the skeletal muscles, dear students. The skeletal muscles or the meat or the flesh of the body is attached to the skeleton. It is under voluntary control, consciously controlled, of course, and its contraction moves the limb and other external body parts. Okay, now if we observe this particular slide under the microscope, so what we can observe over here, dear student, that we can see the alternate light and dark bands, striations. We can say the lines, हमें clearly lighter dark lines दिखेगी. If you take a closely look of this slide, dear students, you can easily observe that light and dark bands are available on this particular slide under the microscope. And this is the result reason also that this particular tissue is also called as striated muscles. Getting, dear students, this tissue is called as skeletal muscle also because they are attached with the bones. This tissue is called as voluntary muscles also because we can move this particular tissue with our conscious will. And this tissue is called as striated muscles also because under the microscope we can observe light and dark bands or light and dark striations. Okay, now what is the structure of the cells of this tissue? That cells of this muscular tissue are long. You can see, dear students, that the cells of this muscular tissue are very much long. You can see, okay, this is the particular below beside this the particular cell is given. It is along in nature, it is cylindrical in shape. You can see a pipe like structure it is having. Okay, so it is called as cylindrical unbranched. कोई branched नहीं है, एक cell में से दूसरा cell out नहीं हो रहा है, means they are unbranched. And multinucleated means having so many nucleus present inside it. Getting, dear students? So this is a single cell of this particular tissue of the, we can say, striated muscle, or we can say voluntary muscle, or we can say the skeletal muscle. So getting, dear students, what is actually this muscle present in, what is actually this tissue present in our body, where it is present, and what are the structure? Getting, dear students? Okay, now we are moving with the second type of tissue. Okay, very first I told you that neuromuscular junction. Dear students, actually what happened whenever our body touches with any hot surface or very cold surface, suddenly we are turning back our hand. Okay, why it happens? Okay, if your friend or anybody else trying to slap you, or if somebody had already slapped you, at that time also you are taking your back, you are taking back your hand, or you are taking back of particular organs of your body. Why? Because the sensation, you feel that people, right, that somebody has touched your muscles. So why it is so? Because the skeletal muscles having the stimulated by motor neurons. Actually, this is the topic which you have to learn in detail in 10th standard, but at least you get the basic idea about that how it will occur and how this happen, that this junction between a nerve fiber and a muscle cell is called a neuromuscular junction. जो भी हमारे nerve cells होते हैं वो हमारे muscles के साथ attached होते हैं. That is why if our body touches with any hot or cold surface, or somebody bites you like any insect or whatever, so you feel that because nerve cells are present on the muscles. I'll show the slide also, dear students. Okay, you can see this is the real slide or real image under the microscope. So you can see over here, dear student. Okay, so you can see over here, dear students, that it is a particular nerve cell attached with the muscles. Okay, and this particular point is called as neuromuscular junction. Neuro means neuron, muscular means muscles, and junction where they both are attached. Okay, so this topic you have to learn in detail in 10th standard, but at least you will get the idea that how this particular thing happens. Okay, moving with the next, that is cardiac muscles. Okay, what, first of all, what do you mean by cardiac muscles, dear students? That the cardiac, it is the meaning related with the heart. That is the muscles of the heart. That which kind of muscles are present in our heart, they are called as cardiac muscles. Also the cardiac muscles are called as involuntary muscles, because hamara koi bas nahi chalta hai, hum agar bole ki hamare heart ke muscles kaam karna band ho jaye, no, it is not, it will not happen, right? So that is why they are called as involuntary muscles. Okay, so moving with it, that cardiac muscle tissue occurs only in the walls of the heart. Cardiac muscle tissue is striated like skeletal muscle tissue. You can see the striation over here on the cardiac muscles. Okay, now the structure of this cardiac muscle is, they are branched. You can see that from one cell different another cells are also produced. So you can see a branch like structure over here. It means that they are branched cell, right? Okay, now cardiac muscles are also called as uninucleated. What do you mean by uninucleated, dear students? Uni means one, and nucleated means nucleus, means they having only single nucleus present into there. Okay, now unlike skeletal muscles, cardiac muscles are also involuntary control, as now I told you. Here example is given, dear students, that when you exercise, nervous of the autonomic nervous system cause an increase in your heart rate in order to deliver more blood to achieve tissue. It is a वेरी कॉम्प्लेक्स सेंटेंस बट आई गेव यू इन अ सिंपल वे डियर स्टूडेंट्स. देखिए जब हम एक्सरसाइज करते हैं तो हम हमारे हार्ट को कहने नहीं जाते दैट नाउ यू हैव टू बीट फास्ट, नाउ यू हैव टू पंप द ब्लड फास्टर एंड फास्टर इन टू माई बॉडी. नो, वो खुद से ही अपना हार्ट रेट बढ़ाकर ज़्यादा अमाउंट में ब्लड हमारी बॉडी को डिलीवर करता है. एंड वेन एवर वी रिलैक्स और स्लीप, जब हम सोते हैं या रिलैक्स्ड मूड में होते हैं, मीन्स कुछ एक्सरसाइज या कुछ हार्ड वर्क नहीं कर रहे होते हैं, फिजिकल वर्क नहीं कर रहे होते हैं, एट दैट टाइम आर ऑटोनॉमिक नर्वस सिस्टम लोअर्स आवर हार्ट रेट डाउन. उसी वक्त अपने आप हमारे हार्ट बीट्स जो होती हैं वो डाउन होती हैं और वी कैन से नॉर्मल होती है. सो दैट इज़ व्हाई दिस पर्टिकुलर दिस इज़ द मेन फंक्शन ऑफ दिस टिश्यू दैट द मसल्स ऑफ द हार्ट शो रिदमिक कॉन्ट्रैक्शन एंड रिलैक्सेशन थ्रू आउट लाइफ. एंड एज नाउ आई टोल्ड यू दैट स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ दिस मसल्स आर दे आर सिलिंड्रिकल, दे आर ब्रांच्ड एंड दे आर यूनिन्यूक्लिएटेड, मीन्स सिंगल न्यूक्लियस इज प्रेजेंट. गेटिंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स अबाउट द कार्डियक मसल्स. ओके, नाउ द लास्ट वन इज स्मूथ मसल्स. ओके, वॉट डू मीन बाई स्मूथ मसल्स? नाउ दैट एज यू गेट द आइडिया दैट स्केलेटल मसल्स आर द मीट ऑफ आर बॉडी, कार्डियक मसल्स आर प्रेजेंट इन द हार्ट ऑफ आर हार्ट, इन साइड द हार्ट. नाउ वॉट आर द स्मूथ मसल्स, वेयर दे आर प्रेजेंट? सो दे आर प्रेजेंट फाउंड मेनली इन द वॉल्स ऑफ द होलो ऑर्गन्स. वॉट डू मीन बाई होलो? जो अंदर से खाली होते हैं, जिनका पाइप लाइक स्ट्रक्चर होता है, फॉर एग्जाम्पल डाइजेस्टिव एंड यूरिनरी ट्रैक्ट, ऑल्सो द ऑर्गन्स लाइक यूटेरस एंड ब्लड वेसल्स. ब्लड वेसल्स, यू ऑलरेडी हैविंग द आइडिया अबाउट डियर स्टूडेंट्स व्हाट डू मीन बाई ब्लड वेसल्स. ओके, नाउ वाई दे आर प्रेजेंट इन डाइजेस्टिव ट्रैक्ट, वाई दे आर प्रेजेंट इन एलिमेंट्री ट्रैक्ट? बिकॉज वॉट एवर द फूड वी आर टेकिंग इट गोज डाउन डायरेक्टली. ओके, हम बोलते नहीं हैं कि खाना नीचे जा जा जा, वो खुद से अपने आप से चला जाता है. सो हियर ऑल्सो दिस पर्टिकुलर मसल टिश्यू इज आर कॉल्ड एज इनवॉलेंटरी टिश्यूज बिकॉज अगेन द कॉन्ट्रैक्शन एंड रिलैक्सेशन अकर्स इन दिस पर्टिकुलर टिश्यू एंड बॉडी मूवमेंट्स अकर. Getting dear students, so that is why they are called as involuntary muscles. Okay, now smooth muscle cells are quite different in appearance from those of the skeletal and cardiac muscles. Now only we had observed that skeletal and cardiac muscles having the cylindrical structure, right? But here no cylindrical structure. You can see the spindle-shaped cells are there. You can see over here that spindle-shaped cells are present as well as no striations. हमें कोई striations नहीं दिखते हैं light and dark. राइट, हमें कोई भी स्ट्रिएशंस नहीं दिखते हैं डियर स्टूडेंट्स हियर. एंड यूनिन्यूक्लियर स्मूथ मसल सेल्स आर स्पिंडल शेप, मीन्स ओनली सिंगल सेल इज प्रेजेंट हियर ऑल्सो. सो रिमेंबर डियर स्टूडेंट्स दैट मल्टी न्यूक्लिएटेड सेल्स ओनली वन टिश्यू हैविंग, दैट इज स्मूथ टिश्यू, सॉरी दैट इज स्केलेटल टिश्यू, राइट? ओके, सो गेटिंग डियर स्टूडेंट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द सेल्स, दैट सेल्स आर एक्चुअली स्पिंडल शेप्ड हैविंग पॉइंटेड एंड्स and uninucleated mean having they are also having a single nucleus, and they are also called as unstriated muscles because not even a single type of striations we can observe over here. So this much only for today, dear students.